Yeah, baby, here they come.
I hate that pity city. I mean, I like these guys, but that pity city thing, I can live without.
Well, they I guess they've been to pity city, and that's the bar. They say that that's just players in the game, and that's the bar. I'm a world tag team.
And they're going to have an opportunity to get rid of that moniker, former World Tag Team Champions, when they face Harlem Heat, the World Tag Team titles, the WCW World Tag Team titles on the line. Capacity crowd here checking out WCW Prime Time. And I'll tell you what, the Nasty Boys are a couple of tough athletes. I mean, technically, hey, what you see is what you get. Physically, they're frightening.
Well, you talked about earlier slow starters. They're not slow starters, and I'll tell you what, the Harlem Heat has really got under their skin. And Sister Sherry there being with the Heat's on a roll, brother. But I think somewhere down the line, the Nasty Boys, they want to reclaim that gold that they had around their waist.
Well, you look at some of the athletes that the Nasty Boys have run out of WCW and gone to lesser wrestling organizations. There are a number of them out. Who was that one big guy that used to play the guitar for us here? Max Payne?
He can play the guitar anyway.
They ran him out of town in a big hurry.
Boom.
Oh, and that's one of the ways he did it. Brian Knobs. And I'll tell you what. Look at him handle Mark Starr.
They seem to be on a mission since losing them titles and going through this thing with Harlem Heat.
They're on a mission, and I remember the night that Jerry Sags lost that front tooth. It happened to be at the Showboat in Las Vegas a long time ago. Came flying across the ring, missed a turnbuckle, hit his mouth on a ring post, knocked his teeth out, and kept on wrestling. Big leg drop.
He's got the power, and that teeth been missing for a long time, and I think now it's kind of a fashion statement with him. He kind of keeps that as a badge on. Oh, no.
This is...
Oh, that's a pit, brother.
Yeah. All right, big hairy Mark Kyle coming in. It's like my kid said to me one day, watching wrestling, he goes, Dad, how come he doesn't shave his back?
Well, the Mark Kyle got hair all over him. Now he's got nasty all over him.
Yeah, he is getting nasty-sized. Well, I'll tell you what, anything would be better than Pity City.
Ooh, man.
And I'd rather pull one of my own teeth than have that happen.
Well, it's a good thing you got a good head of teeth, though. Ooh, good shot right there. Yeah, these guys are really, they ain't taking no prisoners right now because they know they got their work cut out for
them. Look at this.
Whoa, 5 million pounds flying across the ring, brother.
You know, that'd be like sitting at the end of a runway at your local airport, looking up and seeing this psychedelic plane coming at you. Wah! What do you do?
What do
Duck.
You do?
Nowhere to hide in that ring, though.
Here we go now. This is what I call the blibbit move. Coming off the top, and when you got 300 blibbits.
Blibbits?
Blibbit, man. That's 2 pounds in a 1 pound bag.
Oh,
yes.
Wow.
Hung him up.
Elbow right into the solar plexus. Jerry Sags spikes big, hairy Mark Kyle in the center of the ring, and this one is over.
Blibbit, it's not over for the blue Nasty side. Nasty Boys got a date with Harlem Heat. Right here, you see Nasty Boys full control. Whoa, like you said, that big air cap prayer right there at the end of the runway. Old Harry Mark Kyle. The Mark brothers are down, and here it comes. Nasty size off the top of that leg. Gets that 1-2